Now let's talk about implementation of the capsule, and in particular, what are the actions taken on capsule arrival at a particular node? Now I mentioned that the capsule does not contain code, but it is passed by reference, or in other words, what the capsule contains is a type identifier, which is really a fingerprint for the capsule code. And the way this type is generated, it's basically a cryptographic fingerprint of the original capsule code. In the original implementation of ANT's toolkit, they used an MD5 hash of the code and used that as a fingerprint. And it was the case that at the time that this particular research was done, MD5 hash was a cryptographically strong hash function, which was not broken, but subsequently MD5 hash has been broken. But nevertheless, the key thing that I want you to remember is that this type field is a cryptographically strong fingerprint that is derived from the capsule code, and that serves as a reference for the code itself. So when a node receives a capsule, one of two things are possible. The first possibility is that this node has seen capsules of this type before. If that is the case, then it is quite likely that in the soft store of this node, the code that corresponds to this type is already existing, in which case it's a simple thing for the current node to retrieve the code from its soft store and execute the capsule and proceed with forwarding this capsule on towards its desired destination. On the other hand, if this capsule that arrived at this node is the first time that this node is seeing a capsule of this type, then obviously it's not going to have the code that corresponds to this type. In this case, what this current node is going to do is use the previous node field of the capsule and send a request to the previous node saying that, hey, I got this capsule of this type. I don't have the code. Do you have the code? If you have, please send it to me. And when this request comes in, the previous node, obviously, it has processed this capsule before. It's quite likely that this previous node has the capsule code residing in its soft store. And so it retrieves it from its soft store and sends it to the next node so that the next node has the capsule code now, can execute it, and also store it now locally in its own soft store so that future capsules of the same type, when they arrive here, it can be processed using the code that is now stored in the soft store. And the key point to take away is that typically when we're talking about network flows, we are sending a whole bunch of packets, one after the other, and therefore, even though the first packet that comes to a node may not find the code that is associated with that particular type, and may have to do a little bit of heavy lifting in terms of going and reaching back to the previous node to retrieve the code, because network flows is a whole bunch of packets, there's going to be a whole lot of other packets that come down the pike. They're all going to be processed using the soft store and the code that is stored in the soft store. In other words, we are exploiting the locality for capsule processing by storing the code that arrives in response to a request back to a previous node in the local soft store. One concern that we may have is that how do I believe that the code that I got from the previous node is actually the code that corresponds to this type or not? Well, this is where the cryptographically strong fingerprint comes into play. What this node is going to do is when it retrieves the code from the previous node and when the code arrives, it is going to compute the fingerprint of the code that it just got and see if that fingerprint matches the type field of the capsule. If it does, then it knows that this code is genuine. If it is not, then obviously somebody is trying to spoof my node by giving bogus code, so I'm going to reject it. So code spoofing can be avoided by having a fingerprint that is cryptographically strong so that I can recompute the fingerprint, match it against the type, and know that the demand-loaded code that I got is actually the code that is associated with this particular capsule. And as I mentioned already, once I get this code, because I'm going to most likely see capsules of this type in the future, as part of this particular network flow, I'm going to save the code in the soft store for future use. So when a capsule arrives at a node, one of two things will happen. One is I'm going to reach into my soft store and see if I have the code that matches this particular type in the capsule. If it isn't, then I don't have the code. I'm going to reach back and get it from the previous node. But what if I go back to the previous node and the previous node does not have the code that corresponds to this type? So the action of a node when it cannot find the code that corresponds to a type either locally in its soft store or retrieve it from the previous node is to simply drop the capsule. Because what's going to happen is that if this capsule is dropped, higher level acknowledgements that are happening in that particular network flow is going to indicate to the source that something did not get through, and that source node is going to retransmit that capsule. This is exactly the same thing that happens with IP routing on the internet. That is, if a node cannot process all the packet it gets, it simply drops the packet. That's the same semantic that is used for capsule processing also, because we are relying on higher level protocols, the transport protocol that sits on top of the network protocol, do end-to-end acknowledgement to make sure that all the packets that they are expecting have actually reached. And therefore, at the level of capsule processing, we don't have to worry if we cannot process the capsule either locally by using the code in the soft store or by retrieving the code from the previous node, simply drop the capsule. Now, is it likely that when we reach into the previous node, that node does not have the code for it? Because after all, it did process this capsule and send this capsule on to me. It can happen because the soft store is limited. Every router node has only a finite capacity. And all of its capacity is not going to give to a single network flow. It is going to give only a part of its storage for the network flow that is corresponding to a particular capsule type. And therefore, I have to live within my means. So the capsule code may have to throw away stuff every once in a while if it is storing more than what its capacity is in the soft store. So it is possible that the code that it originally stored in the soft store, it had to replace it because it is like a cache, and therefore it may have replaced it, and therefore it may not have it. And this is particularly possible if this request comes at a much later time, because one of the things that you associate with this kind of routing code is that it is going to be timely. So there's going to be a time associated with the validity of things that I want to keep in my soft store. So if I get a request at this node at a much later point in time because a capsule arrived at this node traversing all over the network, it may not have the code that corresponds to the type. So it is possible. So if it happens, simply drop the capsule and let the higher level entities in the protocol stack take care of retransmitting the capsule if need be.